Welcome to InfiMinutes. In this video clip, we are going to discuss the circuit diagram of high-level modulator. We had seen that in high-level modulation transmitter, we do not require power amplifiers after the modulation stage. That is because the modulation takes place at high power level, for which the modulating signal must be power amplified and then given to the modulator. Let us study the circuit diagram of PMCCA, which stands for plate modulated class C amplifier. The previous circuit diagram that we had studied was called grid modulated class C amplifier. This is called plate modulated class C amplifier. The reason is that in grid modulated class C amplifier, we had given modulating signal to the grid terminal. In plate modulated class C amplifier, we are giving modulating signal to the plate terminal, and that's the reason it is called plate modulated class C amplifier. We had said in grid modulated class C amplifier that we are giving modulating signal to the grid terminal because grid signal, grid terminal voltage or current is always of very small amplitude, like base or terminal signal. And hence, when I'm giving grid terminal, when I'm giving modulating signal to the grid terminal, it need not be of very large amplitude and hence large power content. So that is perfectly suitable for low level modulation. In high level modulation, we have power amplified the modulating signal, so it's of large power content. And now we are giving it to the plate terminal, like collector signal. Plate terminal signal is also of a large amplitude compared to the grid terminal. And hence, it suits for high-level modulation because in this case, my signal is power amplified before it goes to the modulator. So you can now see that on the grid terminal, once again, if I start from the grid terminal, on the grid terminal, there is only one tank circuit right now through which we will be giving RF. RF is for carrier. So through this, I'm going to give carrier to the circuit. And this time also there is negative DC supply present. This is my negative DC supply, which instead of giving directly to the grid, I'm giving it through the center tap terminal of the transformer. DC signal through transformer will always reach to the grid terminal because transformer will act as short for the DC signal. But you can see there is no modulating signal given through the grid terminal. So that's all we have on the grid terminal. The cathode terminal of the tube is at ground. Let us now look at the remaining part of the circuit. You can see AF. AF stands for audio frequency signal, which is nothing but my modulating signal. So modulating signal enters the circuit through this side. First circuit in this case is the power amplifier. If you see the circuit very carefully, it is nothing but the class B push-pull power amplifier, where again I'm using tubes as the active devices. Otherwise, in class B push-pull power amplifiers, we also generally use BJTs. But here we are using tube everywhere as the active device. So I repeat this whole structure, which we can see here, of the transformer and two tube devices forms nothing but the power amplifier. To be precise, push-pull class B power amplifier. Class B power amplifiers are always biased in the cutoff region. That means below the conduction region. And for that, we need the negative supply. So there is a negative supply going to the grids of both the tube devices. So the purpose of this power amplifier will be to power amplify my modulating signal so that it can be then given to the modulator circuit. So output of the power amplifier, you can see, is connected to the plate terminal of the modulating device. So we conclude that modulating signal is first power amplified. That is because it is high level modulation, and then it is given to the plate terminal. And for that reason, it is called plate modulated class C amplifier. Through plate terminal, it reaches to the circuit.